Hi everyone, I am Ms. Hu, your physics teacher. And in this video, we're going to look at different kinds of circuits, including series and parallel circuits, and how they can affect the current and voltage. That means we're going to observe how they're going to affect the ammeter and voltmeter readings. We're also going to look at how the brightness of the light bulb changes. So what we're going to do now is we're going to see how to set up a circuit with the battery, the light bulb, ammeter, and voltmeter. The ammeter should always be connected in series with the light bulb and the voltmeter in parallel. First of all, I'm going to explain how to take the reading from the ammeter. So this particular ammeter has two positive terminals. This black color terminal has to be connected to the negative terminal of the battery. The positive terminal can either be connected to either one of these red connections. Now on this button, you can see it says 1 ampere, 1A, and on this one is 5 ampere, 5A. If you take a look at the scale, there are also two sets of readings. You have a number ranging from 0 to 5 on the top and 0 to 1 at the bottom. Now, how do we take the reading? Depending on where we connect the positive connection, that means if you connect it to 1A, you take the reading that ranges between 0 to 1A. If you're connecting it to the 5A, you take the reading between 0 to 5. So that means depending on where the needle lands, whether you read from the top scale or bottom scale, depends on which connection you're using. The same also applies for this kind of voltmeter. You can see it's exactly the same. You have a single negative terminal here, but two choices of the positive terminal. So you have a choice of 1 volt or 5 volts. Exactly the same as the ammeter just now, you have the choice of reading it from the top scale or the bottom scale. So which scale you read from depends on which connection you're making on the red connection.
So here's a simple diagram just to show how the ammeter and voltmeter should be connected to a circuit. And we will be setting up the circuit exactly like in this circuit diagram. The battery here represents the power supply, which are the set of batteries we are using. We have a light bulb, which we need in order to check is the circuit working or not. Because if the light bulb lights up, then we know, yes, the circuit is complete and it's working. We have the ammeter here, which we need to connect in series to the light bulb. And the voltmeter is connected in parallel to the light bulb. Here's the thing about how we make the connections. A lot of students tend to get confused about where they should connect the wires in terms of the negative and positive terminals. This is how you remember it. The power supply provides the electrical energy or electrical power to the entire circuit. The ammeter and voltmeter are components inside the circuit. So how we connect the wires is from the positive terminal of the power supply to the positive terminal of the components. So as you can see from this diagram, the positive terminal of the battery is connected to the positive terminal of the voltmeter and the positive terminal of the ammeter. The negative terminal of the battery is connected to the negative terminal of the ammeter and the negative terminal of the voltmeter. So from the power supply to the components, positive to positive, negative to negative. This means that within the circuit, from component to component, the terminals will be connected to the opposite symbols. For example, ammeter's positive terminal is connected to the negative terminal of the voltmeter. You have to understand it this way. The power supply is providing the electrical power, providing the electrical energy. So the positive needs to go to the positive of the components, negative to negative. So if you look at the circuit, we've got positive to positive. So when it goes in through the positive, it needs to come out through the negative. And then it needs to go in through the next positive and out through the negative. And that's why from component to component, the signs are opposite, from positive to negative. So a lot of students tend to get confused because they're like, how come sometimes it's positive to positive, sometimes it's positive to negative? So remember it this way. From the power supply to component, positive to positive. From component to component, positive to negative. This rule is true for any power supply and any component you use. So whether the power supply is a battery or a dry cell, or whether the components are ammeters, voltmeters, or even diodes, this rule still applies. from power supply to component, positive to positive, negative to negative, and from component to component, positive to negative. Whether you're connecting this in series or parallel, this rule also applies.
So how are we going to make the connection? Okay, so what we're going to do now is we are going to connect the battery to the lamp. Okay. Of course, you can do a test first. Is the lamp working? Yes, it is. It's lighting up. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to connect the ammeter in series. So this side is a positive terminal. This side is a negative terminal. We're going to connect this to the negative terminal. So negative to negative. We have an option now to connect this wire to the 5 ampere or to the 1 ampere. Okay, I'm going to connect it to the bottom for clarity. Now, if we connect this to the 5 ampere button, you can see that the reading appears to be much lower, whereas if we connect it to the 1 ampere, the reading appears to be much higher. They're both actually exactly the same number. It just depends on which scale we're going to read, depending on which connection we make. So if we connect it to the 1 ampere connector, you can see that the reading is actually about 0.24. Now, if we connect it to the 5 ampere connection, it's actually the same. It's also about 0.2 something, but because the number is a lot smaller on such a large scale, we can't really see the value. So whether you connect it to 5A or 1A, it depends on which scale would be easier for you to take the reading off. So in our case, we're going to connect it to the 1 ampere connection because that number is a lot easier to read. Now, for the voltmeter, we're going to connect this in parallel to the light bulb. So it's going to get a little messy because there are going to be crocodile clips that are clipping onto the very same point. So I'm going to clip it this way because it's a lot more stable for now. So for the voltmeter now, we're going to connect this in parallel with the lamp. Right, so this side is the negative. So we're going to connect the negative terminal to the negative point. Okay, so we're going to connect the negative to the negative. And then positive to the positive. So similarly, the voltmeter has options of 1 volt and 5 volt. Now, if you connect 1 volt, you might find that this happens. That means the needle is pointing way above the scale. What this tells us is that the voltage is more than 1, which is why it's not able to show a reading, because it's now greater than 1. So if we connect it to the 5 volt, now we can get a reading. So looking at the scale, you can see that the number is about 2.3 volts. Now, if you ever have a situation where the needle appears to be behind the 0, like this, this means that we have made the connections wrongly. That means this should be connected to the negative and this should be the positive because the current is now flowing in the opposite direction. So the needle is now behind the 0. So if you make the change, you can now get the reading. So if you ever have a situation where the needle is behind the 0, that means the current is flowing in the wrong direction. So our terminals are connected incorrectly. So swap the connections around. So this goes to the negative and this goes to the positive. Okay, and okay, the ammeter is a bit loose. And now you can see that there is a reading on the ammeter. Now, let's take a look at how to set up series circuits. Now, it's always a good idea to test whether the batteries and the light bulbs are working. So what we could do is test them individually first by just checking one light bulb at a time. So this light bulb works. And so does this light bulb. So the reason why we want to check them individually is because sometimes after setting up the entire circuit, we'll find that none of the light bulbs light up and you don't know what went wrong. So it's possible that one light bulb has spoiled, but it has caused the entire circuit to not work. So by testing them individually before we start the experiment, that enables us to know for sure everything's working, so that when the circuit doesn't work, it's easier to find out what's wrong and how to fix it. So if something is already not working, then we know don't use that component, change it for something that actually works.
This is the circuit diagram for our series circuit, which we have set up in this video. This circuit was set up to compare the values of the ammeter and voltmeter. As you can see, from the battery to the voltmeters and ammeters, we have positive connected to positive, negative to negative, while from every component to component, it's positive to negative. Here, we have two light bulbs connected in series, and we have a voltmeter connected across each of these light bulbs, and an ammeter connected in series to each of these light bulbs as well. In a series circuit, you will find that the ammeter readings, which represent the current, would be the same. The voltmeter readings could differ depending on the light bulbs. In this case, it so happens that the light bulbs we use are identical. That's why the voltmeter readings are also identical. If the light bulbs were not the same and they have different values of resistance, the voltmeter readings would be different. The current, however, would still remain the same. For a series circuit, you can see that the current that's flowing from the battery is all flowing along one path only. And that's why the current is the same throughout the circuit and the ammeter readings are the same. Some of you may wonder, what about the current that's flowing through the voltmeter that's in parallel? Wouldn't that count? The current that's flowing through is actually so small, for our syllabus, it's negligible. We don't have to take into account the current that's flowing through the voltmeter.
So to connect this in series, what we're going to do is we're going to clip this, and then we'll take another crocodile clip, connect them in series, like so. And you can see that the light bulbs are now on. Now, let's check how the ammeter reading would be like. When connecting the ammeter, you need to connect the negative terminal of the battery to the negative terminal on the ammeter and a positive terminal to the positive terminal on the ammeters, which means that if this is the negative terminal, from here through the light bulb, this needs to go to the negative terminal. This side, positive, will go to the positive terminal. Which means that this negative goes to this positive. You can see the readings here. Okay, you can't see it because the crocodile clips are blocking. So I'm going to adjust it so that you can see it. And you can see here that the current readings are the same, which means that the current that flows through a series circuit is the same. Take a look at how to connect these light bulbs in parallel.
This is a circuit diagram of two light bulbs connected in parallel in a complete circuit. Again, just to point out to you, the positive-negative connections still apply in this case. As you can see, from the battery to the voltmeters and ammeters, they're positive to positive and negative to negative, while from the ammeter to voltmeter, they're connected from positive to negative. We've got two light bulbs in parallel here, and the purpose of this circuit is to compare the ammeter and voltmeter readings. Whether the light bulbs are identical or not, you will find that the voltmeter readings would be the same. If the light bulbs were identical, because they have the same resistance, therefore they will have the same current, so the ammeter readings would be the same. If the light bulbs were not identical, then the resistance would be different and the ammeter readings would be different. In this video though, we are using identical light bulbs, hence the ammeter readings would be the same. However, in this video, I did add an extra ammeter in order to compare the ammeter readings. So you can see that for each of these branches, they have their own ammeters, and the extra ammeter now is on the outside of the parallel connections. So when we compare the ammeter readings, you will find that this ammeter, which is outside the parallel connection, would be much higher compared to the other two. The ammeter reading on the outside of the parallel section would be equal to the sum of the ammeter readings inside the parallel section. This is because when the current flows from the battery, when it reaches the parallel section, the current would split, and at this point, they will join together again, and that's why the current here in this ammeter would be the sum of the current flowing through these two branches.
So we're going to connect this here. For this light bulb, you have the option to connect it directly to this light bulb as well, or you can connect it direct to the dry cell. So you can see in this connection, the light bulbs are quite bright with the same brightness. And that's because the lamps are identical. It only works when the lamps are identical. So, just to prove that the voltage and parallel circuits are the same, we're going to take a look at the voltmeter readings across the lamps as well. You can see that the voltmeters are connected in parallel to the components. This voltmeter is connected in parallel to the dry cells. That's the reading. This voltmeter is connected in parallel to the first lamp. And this voltmeter is connected in parallel to the second lamp. And you can see that the readings of all the voltmeters are the same. I hope you found this video educational and helpful. Don't forget to click like and hit subscribe. Switch on your notifications so that you can get updates on when videos just like these about experiments and practicals will be released by Ms. Ho. Happy studying!